FactsVerse presents. These habits were totally rad in the 60s, but we'd never try them out today. Compared to today, the 60s seemed like it took place on a different planet. TV shows were in black and white, phones were connected to the wall, digital technology didn't exist. Back in the 60s, we were much less careful than we are today, but we had less to worry about back then, too. These habits were totally rad in the 60s, but we would never try them out today. Before we get into our list, jump down to the comments and let us know if there are any trends from the 60s that you liked and wouldn't mind seeing come back. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. Dangerous toys. Today, toys are usually pretty safe. For toy manufacturers to avoid lawsuits from angry parents of injured children, toys go through rigorous safety tests. In the 60s, toy safety wasn't as big of an issue. There were safe toys around back then, like Monopoly and Candyland. You don't usually hear about a kid being hurt while passing Go. There were, however, plenty of dangerous toys on the market. The Swing Wing was just one of them. It was a hula hoop attached to a helmet. To keep the hula hoop going, you had to swing your head around using a whiplash motion. Neck, back, and head injuries were common with this toy. Another dangerous toy was jarts. These were darts with dangerously sharp ends. They would fly through the air like a javelin and then land on other kids. Getting a jart to the eye could prove to be fatal. There were also plenty of BB guns and cap guns available to kids, which could cause serious injuries. Today, due to the number of school shootings and other gun violence in the news, any type of toy gun is considered unacceptable. A lot of the toys from the 60s would never be found on toy store shelves today. Ironing your hair. Hair fashions come and go all the time. During the 60s and 70s, pin straight hair was popular. During the 80s, perms and high hair were popular. From the 90s until today, straight hair has become popular again. Today, we have flat irons to straighten our hair out. They're easier to use and they're also safer than what we did in the 60s. Back then, the irons weren't available, so if a woman wanted her hair to be pinned straight, she had to use a different, more dangerous method. Girls in the 60s used a clothes iron to straighten their hair. A woman would lay her hair over the ironing board and a friend would iron her hair, the same way you'd iron clothes. This was extremely dangerous, of course, because irons get so hot that it's not safe for the hair. That is a huge fire hazard. And while this was effective in straightening the hair, it would also burn the hair. Many women of the 60s were forced to cut their long hair because they accidentally burned it. Those who attempted to iron their own hair were very likely to burn it because they couldn't see what they were doing. It's something that you would never see women doing today, at least not any women with an IQ at all. Car safety. Back in the 60s, nobody really thought much about car safety. Young kids were allowed to sit up front with their parents without wearing a seatbelt. The only protection they had was their mom and dad's flinging arm when coming to a short stop. Seatbelts back then were kind of pointless because they only went across the lap. It wasn't very effective in helping an adult or a child in an accident. Babies were put in car seats that didn't get strapped into the car. The car seat was either placed in the front seat with the child's parent or on a parent's lap. Toddlers were put in unsophisticated car seats or just placed in the back seat without anything special. Most kids in the 60s remember sitting on a parent's lap while they were driving so that the child could have a chance to drive the car too. If the family had a pickup truck, it wasn't uncommon for kids to pile in the back of the truck on a beautiful day. Today, everything I just said is illegal. Children cannot ride in the front seat for any reason. Passenger side airbags can decapitate a child sitting in the front seat. It's illegal for both adults and children to ride in the car without a seatbelt, a seatbelt, in fact, that must meet the current seatbelt regulations. Babies are required to be in an approved car seat, facing the rear of the vehicle until they reach a certain height or weight. When they have, they then are placed in a front-facing car seat. Booster seats are necessary for any child under 80 pounds or under the age of 8. If parents allowed their children to ride in the bed of a pickup truck today, they'd find themselves in jail for endangering the life of a child. The way children traveled in the 60s is shocking. Drinking from the garden hose. Kids in the 60s and 70s, they spent most summer days playing outside. When they became thirsty, their parents would tell them to take a drink from the hose outside instead of coming in here and getting the house dirty. Hey, back then, hoses were not regulated the way drinking water inside the home was. When 60s parents told their kids to take a drink from the hose outside, They didn't realize that their kids were being exposed to unsafe levels of lead while they drank. They also didn't know that the brass nozzle was a danger as well, because it could expose the child to lead as well. Today, kids go outside to play and their parents will leave them a bottle of water on the way out. Due to the dangers of lead and the potential dangers of the water, kids don't drink from the hose at their parents' request anymore. Which is too bad because, man, that water was tasty. Hey, if you grew up in the 70s, you know what I'm talking about. So did you do any of these things when you were growing up? Tell us in the comments and subscribe for more.